Welcome back everyone. After a long break, I am doing a video in English language. So Nano Lube, the engine oil additive that we have been hearing about as Kerala's own invention. We hear that when using it, the engine becomes much smoother, has more power, less engine heat, and many positive things happen to the engine. So what this actually is? What technology is inside it that even the big engine oil companies can't find? I did a little research about it because I too had that in my mind. So what I have found is in this video. If you have the same thoughts and doubts in your mind, then watch the video. I too tried the Nano Lube, so will also tell you about my experience. Before knowing what Nano Lube is, we need to know what this nano is in it. Nano is short for nanoparticle and nanotechnology. Nanoparticles are very, very small particles, precisely 1 to 100 nanometers in size. So now you also understand that there is a measurement called nanometer. Do you know how much is a millimeter? The distance between the two shortest lines on a standard scale is 1 millimeter, say mm. This 1 millimeter is 1 million nanometers. Shocked? That is the size of a nanometer or nm. It is that much small. Let's give another example to understand that size. Do you know how small the COVID virus is? The size of a COVID virus is 50 to 140 nanometers. Now you may understand a little more about what a small size we are talking about. So the particles with a size of 1 to 100 nanometers are called nanoparticles. That is only the size of a virus or less than that. Nanotechnology is the technology of making them and designing and making new things with it. So nanotechnology is already there, but is Nano Lube something new? Not at all. It's too been here for a long time. So let's get to what is Nano Lube. Simply put, Nano Lube is an oil mixed with nanoparticles. So what are those particles? A quickly understandable example is Liqui-Moly's MOS2. MOS2 is molybdenum disulfide. It contains nanoparticles of molybdenum disulfide. Nanoparticles of MOS2 are added to a carrier oil. Another one is boric acid. The nanoparticles of boric acid or boron are used in the Nano Lube of Arch Oil, a company in the United States. Also, nanoparticles of copper, graphene, alumina, silica, copper oxide, zinc oxide, titanium dioxide, tungsten disulfide, hexaboron nitride, multi-walled carbon nanotubes, and many other materials are used for Nano Lube. Before knowing how these nanoparticles reduce friction and wear, do you know how oil reduces friction? That is the first thing to know. To know all this, you need to know what friction is. In the case of machines, when two moving metal parts come together and move to opposite sides, friction is the force that stops it. That is the state one prevents the other from sliding or moving freely. That is friction in a simple way. So why is there such a friction? There are two things. One, friction is felt by an adhesion between two materials. But this is not the friction in machines we are talking about. No matter how smooth and polished the surface of a part may seem to us, if we look at it through a microscope, it will be full of bumps and pits. When we are looking at the road below from a high altitude or sitting in an aircraft, we will not see any of the pits there. Everything will be very beautiful. But only when you see it up close, you will know that it was like this. Same here also. So this is what is stopping each other. This is what creates the friction. So what oil does on a surface like this is fill these pits and make them level, then make a layer of oil like a thin film on both surfaces and help it slide freely without giving a chance to those bumps and pits to touch each other. This is how oil prevents wear in the engine and transmission. Without oil, all this would not last even 5 minutes. But this film of oil and its power of keeping these two surfaces away does not always work. Oil is a liquid anyway. When there is a sufficient mechanical load, this oil layer will be broken and these bumps will rub each other. That's how the engine parts get damaged. At this time comes the entry of our hero, nanoparticles. Because oil is a liquid, it can be removed quickly from these pits and the surfaces can rub together. No matter how small these nanoparticles are, they are solid matter. It is not soluble in oil. It remains suspended in oil. When we pour it into the engine oil and start the engine, it comes with the oil and filling these pits and making these surfaces smooth. Like the example of potholes on the road are covered by putting soil or rock waste to make the surface smooth. This is called the mending effect. After that, it lies between these metal surfaces and rolls like marbles and reduces the friction between them. A ball bearing effect. The sliding friction becomes a very small rolling friction. This is called the rolling effect. As it rolls on the surface, it will also rub off the rough parts of the surface. It is called the polishing effect. Not only that, the rest of the nanoparticles along with the oil will form a layer between the two surfaces, a protective film. The difference is that unlike oil, these nanoparticles are solid and the engine parts cannot quickly push them away and rub against each other. So in these four ways, nanoparticles prevent engine wear. So NanoLube is not a myth. It is the thing that has the capacity to reduce the friction in the engine and gearbox a lot. Now let's come to Kerala's own NanoLube. Firoz Mustafa, an IT engineer, became a tribology scientist when he realized the deficiencies of engine oils used in his own vehicles. Actually, oil companies made him a scientist. The breakthrough came when a UK-based lubricant manufacturer, which supplies NanoLube to space agencies like NASA and ISRO, called him and offered help. Now the nanoparticles needed for this lube comes from them. But the product called NanoLube was able to be made out of it because of Firoz's long hard work. Marketing and commercial production has now started under the brand Armorol Ultra NanoLube. We would like to know what that nanoparticle material is, but we cannot. It is Firoz's trade secret. I understand it is not the materials that we mentioned earlier. It should be their own proprietary product developed by that UK-based company. But it is a material similar to MOS2 and tungsten disulfide. It has been said on Firoz's YouTube channel. It is mentioned as 50mm size nanoparticles on the outside of the pack, but should come as NM, nanometer. Now, in the new batch, there are nanoparticles in size from 2nm to 50nm. They are spherical particles. So it can be understood that this is the same as a normal nanoparticle. Now comes the question of how effective Armorol Ultra NanoLube is. Firoz is still here with NanoLube only because of the testimony of people who have used this NanoLube for years before me. There is no need for any proof beyond that. Not only that, Firoz himself has done the test of wear with and without adding NanoLube on his YouTube channel so that we can understand it very easily. In this video, we can see the effectiveness of NanoLube clearly. We have talked about the benefits of NanoLube for so long. Not only that, but we are also looking at whether it has any negative effects. Before that, let's see how to use this Nano Ultra Lube. This 100ml pack is priced at ₹1,200. Now listed on Amazon, I bought it there. I didn't get it for free, so you can expect an unbiased review from me. How to use it is given in the brochure of Armorol. First, shake this can well, because nanoparticles will be settled on the bottom of the can. So you have to shake it to mix it. If the engine oil is changing, it can be poured into the bottle of oil itself, shaken and mixed, and poured into the engine. Or you can put it in the engine oil directly like this. It is very important to start the engine and let it idle for 20 minutes after adding NanoLube. Otherwise, these particles may settle at the bottom of the engine in the oil sump. Then it is not sure that it will reach everywhere in the engine by pumping it. You must remember that. It is said that the difference starts to be felt after the first 30 km. And after running 1000 km or 30 hours of engine operation, the complete difference can be seen. From cars to heavy vehicles, this 100ml NanoLube is enough. Generally, 50ml is recommended for all bikes and scooters and 100ml for Royal Enfield bikes. In non-Royal Enfield bikes, pouring more than 50ml will cause the clutch to slip. It is said in the brochure that it can be used even once. Can be used in every oil change if desired. I think it's best to use it on alternate oil changes. My car has driven less than 100 km since I poured it. Even if the difference is small, can be noticed. It feels like the engine is a little quieter and smoother. This is my initial impression. Now let's come to whether nano loop has any disadvantages. It can be understood that a lot of studies have been done in this regard. Much research has been published on the internet itself. You will get bored if I explain all that. So let's summarize one or two things. The biggest problem is dosage itself. It has been found in many researchers that without the correct dosage, there will be a negative effect. A joint research was conducted by an engineer at Ashok Leyland and professors at Vellore Institute of Technology, VIT. It has been published on ResearchGate. In the test conducted with boron nanoparticles, it was found that when 10% of the oil recommended by the loop company was added to the cast iron sample, it caused more wear than the oil without the additive. That is, when oil with boron additives was used, the wear track increased. It is a shocking result. Engine cylinder wall lining and piston rings are cast iron. It is the wear track of pure oil. This is the result of adding a 10% boron nano additive. How much is it can be understood a little more clearly in this graph. The red line is with borium added. The black line is just oil. The width and depth of the wear track are increased with the addition of borium. But when the quantity of the additive was increased to 20 and 30%, the amount of wear decreased. The negative effect was on the company's recommended dosage. It should be understood that the company has decided on the dosage without conducting sufficient studies. But in the hardened carbon steel, which represents the gear wheels, generally the wear decreased. In the 10% ratio recommended by the company, the wear is much reduced than just oil. But it can be seen that the wear is increasing at 20%, but it is decreasing again in 30%. This blue line indicates the result of the test done on the nano copper additive. In all three samples, it can be seen that the wear has increased greatly in cast iron. It is more in 20% than in 10%, but at 30%, it is slightly less than that. In carbon steel, it gradually increases in all three samples. From this test, it was understood that nano copper additive is not only a waste but also destroys the engine. But borium gave confusing results. In cast iron, the wear increased in the company recommended 10%. But in carbon steel, it gave the best result. In general, if the quantity of nanoparticles increases beyond a certain limit, there will be a phenomenon called agglomeration, in which they all join together. It will remove all the qualities that we have seen as belonging to the nanoparticle and will have the opposite effect, increasing the wear. But we have seen that even if the quantity decreases, it is a problem like in the case of borium. So correct dosage is very important. It cannot be done by us customers. Companies should do the necessary research and tests to find out. I think that things are different with Armorall Nano Lube. I understand from their FAQ answers that their nanoparticle is not a rubbing material like borium or copper. It is said that their nanoparticle is a softer material than graphite and Teflon. At high pressure, these nanoparticles will sink into the pits on the surface as we have seen earlier, and after that, it will become a coating on that surface. BMW warns in the owner's manual that under no circumstances should molybdenum-based additives be used in G310 as it may attract the anti-wear coating on engine components. It is said that most companies do not promote these types of additives, and the reason for this is that they actually want the engine and parts to wear and damage. I am not sure how accurate that would be. And it has been seen from some research that some nano additives are effective in some grade oils. In this graph, we can see that the popular molybdenum disulfide additive is the most effective and has the most friction reduction in the test with SAE50, a monograde oil that is not used as a common engine oil. But it is also shocking that it does not make any difference in the 5W40 and 20W40 oils that are widely used. It is one of the most sold additives in India. Similarly, copper oxide additive also has the most benefit in SAE50. Not only that, we can see the results we saw earlier in nano copper here. The coefficient of friction has increased in 10W30 and 15W40 grade oils. In terms of titanium dioxide, it can be seen that it is more effective in 10W30 than 5W30 oil. That means many nanoparticles are effective in certain grade oils. All these are said just for your understanding of the situation. But I can say now that there is no such confusion in the case of Armorall Nano Lube. there needs to be more research to see if there are any long-term side effects. Until then, we can put our faith in Firoz, a hardworking, knowledgeable, good guy. I'm testing it on my bike and scooter too, and we will know in the coming days what changes it made to the car engine in the long term. Like and subscribe for that. There is another nano loop that I found during this research that I found very surprising. That might be in another video. See you next week in the new video. Thank you so much for watching.